Well, the SEC has screwed us again. Hi and welcome back, everybody. Hope you all are having a fantastic day out there. Got some things I want to cover here in this quick video. Not all negative, I can promise you that. All we ever ask is if you like talking XRP, XOM, digital assets, and getting these updates, drop an X in the comment section below. Smash that like button. Give us a big thumbs up so we know. And of course, share this content. Let others around the world know what is truly happening in this digital revolution. As we see the SEC postponing X's Hex is ETH spot ETF, as well as Franklin Templeton's ETF Bitcoin there. And you say to yourself, are you surprised? More delays. How many times are they going to delay these ETFs as Gary Gensler just continuously kicks the can down the road, like turtle pace is what this gentleman is going, while the whole entire world of blockchain awaits. Now, you may say to yourself, why do you care so much about Bitcoin ETFs and other ETFs and so forth? Well, Grayscale's ETF, part of their product there will be XLM, which is one of the cryptos we talk about every single day here on this channel. We also know that an XRP ETF is in the making, will be in the making in the future, guaranteed. And so I am pro crypto. I am pro innovation. I am pro blockchain. I am pro everything. I want this emerging market to start moving. And if it just so happens that Bitcoin ETFs are approved and it helps the entire market, that's a plus, right? And so Bitcoin, obviously, nothing against it at all. I'm not going to be one of those out there that says, stay as far away from Bitcoin as you possibly can. I'm not of that mindset. But when you compare it to XRP, you compare it to XLM and what they will do for the financial world in terms of on and off ramps, what's going to happen in terms of enhancing banking systems, XRP and XLM will remain the top winners in my personal opinion, my book. So with that being said, as all this is happening, we see Stellar helping 350 million unbanked Africans. We see Ripple again and again come out with more and more bullish news. I just did a video yesterday where I talked about just seven of the things just this year they have done that puts them way and far ahead of basically every cryptocurrency out there. And I like to kind of lump cryptos together in same sectors as XRP and XLM versus saying they're direct competitors, because I don't really view XRP and XLM as direct competitors. They're still going after cross-border payments. But when you take a look at XRP, what they're going to do for banks, and XLM peer-to-peer, kind of a different sector in a way, if you look at it in that sense. Regardless, yes, I am a little frustrated. You can probably hear it in my voice. But when you take a step back, take a deep breath, you say to yourself, we are in the right industry here. We are in the right lane. And as long as we stay the course, right, we're going to be okay. I see big dips in the market. If I got some money to deploy into these cryptocurrencies that I believe, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to continue to do. I'm going to continue to buy XRP. I'm going to continue to buy XLM, anything under a dollar until these cryptocurrencies absolutely explode, because that's 100% what I believe and my conviction. Now, whatever you want to do with your money is 100% up to you, but this is what I believe. These are two of the top dogs out there, and they will help the new financial system become an effective, efficient system. That's all I got for you for now. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, share the content, turn on those notification bells, and we'll see you all in the next video.